So most of us have, at this point in our lives, have probably used a chatbot, maybe without even knowing it. Have you ever wondered, how does a chatbot work? What powers it? How do I interact with it? Let's dive in. My name's Morgan Carroll with IBM Cloud. Let's say you're the owner of a flower shop. This is you. And you're the only employee. Maybe you don't have time to respond to common customer inquiries, such as, what time do you open? Do you have yellow roses in stock? How do I contact you? So you've got your customer up here and they need to get in touch with you, but you're busy, you can't answer the phone. So what can we do to solve this problem? This is where Flora, the Floral chatbot, comes in. This is Flora over here. Now, if a customer has a simple question, let's say they just wanna know, what time do you guys open? They can ask Flora, hey, what time do y'all open? And then Flora is gonna be able to respond with the appropriate answer. She's gonna say, you know, maybe we open Monday at 9 a.m. All without me having to interact with the chatbot or the customer so that I'm free to do what I love to do, which is designing floral arrangements. Now let's think of a more complex example. Say you have the bank here. And you, as the customer, you would like to check and see what your balance is. So I just got paid, I don't know how much money is in the bank, but I need to go buy some socks. So rather than having to call the bank and wait on hold and wait for a teller to pull up your information and check your account status, you could actually interact with Birdie, the banking bot. So in this case, I'm gonna ask Birdie, what is my balance? How much money do I have currently? Birdie's gonna come back and ask, I can help you with that, but what is your account number, your PIN number, you know, some identifying information? So I'm gonna be able to provide this information back to Birdie, my account number, maybe my date of birth, a PIN number, et cetera, et cetera. From there, all without any tellers or any employees having to interact with Birdie, she's gonna be able to go and ask the bank. She's gonna pass along all this information, my account number, my date of birth, and my PIN number. And she's gonna say, hey bank, how much money does this person have in their account? The bank is gonna authorize me and say, okay, this is all the appropriate information that we need. The bank is gonna respond with, I'm sorry, you only have $5. Maybe enough for socks, maybe not. But then Birdie is gonna be able to take that response and pass it back to me, the customer, all without having to interact with any humans, and it's very simple. So how does this really work? Let's dive in. Going back to the floral shop example, let's say tomorrow is Mother's Day and you forgot to order flowers like we normally do. So here's you, my customer. Now, like we mentioned before, the floral shop owner is very busy. She's putting together all these arrangements. She doesn't really have time to answer the phone. So luckily there are a few different ways that you, the user, can interact with our chatbot to actually automate ordering some flowers for your mother. So on the floral shop website, there could be a little pop-up maybe at the bottom that has Flora. This is Flora, the floral bot. And she's here and she's gonna be able to pop up and ask me, what kind of flowers would you like to order? Obviously yellow roses because those are my mother's favorite. If we don't want to use the website, we could actually just call in. So it can be either text-based or voice-based. So if I call the chatbot, she says, welcome to Flower Supply 101. What would you like to place your order for? I would say, I would like a dozen yellow roses, and it's just conversational, and she's gonna take my order and be able to process it. And you can also use various instant messaging services, you know, for different social media platforms you can integrate. So you have all these different ways that you can interact with the chatbot. Now let's think about how that actually works sort of on the back end. So I think by now we're all familiar with the cloud. It's the buzzword of the year. This is actually where our chatbot is gonna live. So you'll have a chatbot service provider. And this chatbot is gonna integrate with various services to actually process whatever speech it is that the user is saying. It's gonna use natural language processing as well as artificial intelligence to take what I'm saying and then actually translate it into something that a computer can understand. So I'm saying, whether it's via phone or via instant messenger or to the web page via text or voice, I would like to purchase some yellow roses. I'll say purchase yellow roses. And maybe I want to do a dozen. Maybe next year I'll do two dozen. I should. So then it's going to pass this. I'm going to pass this information to either the web page or IM or voice. This is actually, whatever this medium is, it's going to send this information up to the cloud. Now the cloud is going to take this and it's going to process it. It's going to say, I see that the user wants to purchase this specific item. In this case, 12 yellow roses. Now we have to make sure that we actually have these roses in stock. You know, if I try to place an order and then I pay for it and then I get a notice, sorry, we're out of stock. Well, that's just not a good user experience. So the way this is going to work is we'll use various cloud services, and we're actually going to go over here and connect to what I'm going to call Floral Systems. And this is basically just going to be our database on the back end. And it's going to show, you know, maybe I have 36 yellow roses in stock. I've also got, let's say 14 red tulips and 3 succulents. So, I've sent this information to the web page already as the user. Now the web page is going to say, all right, purchase, and then 12 roses, yellow roses. Now, this is going to send this information to the cloud, to my chatbot service provider, and then that is actually going to go out here and check the database. So I'll say 12 yellow roses is what we're looking for, and then we can see. We've actually got 36, so we have plenty of roses. This is good. So now we're going to send a response back. We're going to say, yes, we have more than enough roses in stock, so we can go ahead and place this order. And the cloud is going to come back and say, yes, let's place this order. And then the web page is going to come back to me and say, absolutely, you're in luck. You didn't wait too long. Maybe next year try to do it a little quicker, but we're going to be able to fulfill your order. So then I'm over here the whole time as, let's say I'm over here, the floral shop owner, and I'm just building floral arrangements. Maybe I'll get a notification kind of off to the side, but all in all, the whole thing is automated, so I don't have to stop what I'm doing to actually take care of this, and it's going to save me a lot of time. Now let's talk about the benefits of, you know, why would we want to use a chatbot? I mean, it is nice to have that human interaction whenever you're dealing with your customers, but I think probably the number one reason that someone may want to use a chatbot is to save time. And what I mean by that is, you know, not only are you saving time when it comes to like interacting with your customers and getting someone to place an order, but again, you're leaving time off to the side for you to go and, you know, maybe you've got to do some bookkeeping. You've got to put these floral arrangements together. Whatever it is, it's going to save you hours and hours over the course of even just a month. Two, simplicity. Chatbots, believe it or not, are surprisingly simple to build. You don't have to know how to write any code in most cases. If you want to do more in-depth integrations, you might need to know some code. But for the most part, it's just natural language based. You could say, hey, chatbot, I want you to tell users that I'm open Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And it's going to be able to relay that information without having to know any Python or JavaScript or anything like that. Lastly, time to launch. So what that means is that it does not take a lot of time to build a chatbot. Like I said earlier, you don't have to know any code. And since it's cloud-based, you don't have to build up any of the underlying infrastructure. From the time you start building the chatbot to the time it's completed, could be as quick as 1 hour. And so these are some of the reasons that you may want to build a chatbot for your business. So I hope this helped explain what a chatbot is, how it works, and why you may want to use it. Thank you for watching. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe. And don't forget, you can grow your skills and earn a badge by creating your own chatbot by clicking the link below.